Welcome back to the Bookbinding e-course. This is lesson 2, and today we'll be learning how to do the actual bookbinding. We'll be binding your book by sewing the book signatures together. So let's get started. Before we can start the actual bookbinding, we will need to prepare the thread by waxing it. First, prepare the thread. For a start, cut out a length of thread that's about 10 to 15 times the height of your book. Do note that the longer the thread, the easier it is for it to tangle up during the bookbinding process. Don't worry about running out of thread during the bookbinding. It is okay to extend your thread during the bookbinding process, and we will be showing you how we do that at the later part of this video. Once you have measured out the thread, it's time to wax the thread. Press the thread on a candle and pull the whole length across. You can wax it twice to make sure that the whole thread is covered with wax. Waxing the thread will reduce occurrence of thread entanglement during the bookbinding and also ensures that the binding process is smooth. It also helps to protect your book signatures during the bookbinding process. An unwaxed thread can cause tears along the holes during the bookbinding process. Once the waxing is done, put the thread through your needle. Bring the two ends together and tie a knot. Do leave some space at the end of the knot. Now that your thread is ready, it's time to start binding your book. Start from one end of your first book signature. Here, we started from the left side, so all the instructions will be referenced from the left. Insert your needle from the outside of the book signature towards the inside. Pull the thread through and bring your needle to the second hole. Again, pull your thread through. Next, continue on to the third hole and pull the thread through. This time, instead of going all the way, pause, insert a linen tape before you complete the process of pulling the thread through. Continue on for all the holes, weaving in and out of the book signature. The linen tape will be inserted along the outside of the book signature every time the thread goes along the spine. You should use 3 linen tape in this process. Continue sewing and complete your first book signature. Once you're done, grab your second book signature and start sewing from the right side. Again, entering from the outside of the book signature towards the inside. Make sure that you remember to place the linen tape in between the thread and the book signature. Continue sewing and complete your book signature. Once you reach the last hole of your book signature, pull the thread through and tie a triple knot between the needle end of the thread and the starting end of the thread. This will bind the first two book signatures together. Do remember to refer to your PDF guide if you need a detailed visual guide. Once you've tied the triple knot, let's move on to the third book signature. Continue on with your third book signature, starting from the left side. Once you reach the end of your third book signature, bind the third book signature onto your first and second book signatures. Bring your needle around the thread that binds the first and second book signature together. Pull the thread through. Before pulling the thread all the way through, bring your needle through the resultant loop. This will form a knot that will hold the three book signatures together. Continue on to your fourth book signature. Repeat the sewing pattern, weaving in and out along the spine of your book signature. Remember to tuck the linen tape along the spine of your book signature. At the end of your fourth book signature, repeat the process of joining your book signatures together. Bring your needle around the thread that connects the second and third book signature. Pull the thread through and bring your needle around the resultant loop that forms. Tighten the knot to bind your fourth book signature together with the rest of the book. Continue this process to join all your book signatures together. During the bookbinding process, you may need to extend your thread. To do so, firstly finish up the remaining thread. Aim to stop at the ends of the book signature and not in the middle, because stopping in the middle will create a random knot that may not look so nice, especially if you are not making a book cover. Go around the thread that connects the previous book signatures and form a knot by going through the resultant loop. Cut off any excess thread and remove it from the needle. Next, we prepare a new thread. Again, wax the thread before you use it. Put it through the needle, bring both ends together and tie a knot. Now we are ready to continue with the binding process. Bring the needle around the region where you ended the previous thread. Form a knot by going through the resultant loop. Repeat this process to form a double knot before you continue with the book binding process. Do take note of your thread as you go along your book binding. A long thread has a higher chance of entangling, so just stay calm, undo the entangle, and continue your book binding. Once you reach the end of your last book signature, join the signature together with the rest of the book by bringing the needle around the thread between the previous two book signatures, followed by bringing the needle through the resultant loop and forming a knot. Repeat this process twice to create a double knot before you cut off the excess thread. And congratulations, we're done with today's lesson. You should now have an incomplete book that's starting to shape up. Stay tuned for lesson 3 that's coming tomorrow. We'll be learning how to make your book spine in that lesson. See you then!